Hello, Patrick Walchuk with an update on the Ottawa real estate market to the end of January 2016. So, in terms of residential property, that's anything that is not a condo. The number of units sold, or the number of homes sold, was down 8%. And the average price of one of these residential properties is now $387,000, which is an increase of 5% in prices. So units down 8, prices up 5. Condominiums, this is all types, row units and apartments. The number sold is up 13%. And the average price of a condo is $250,000, which is a decline of 1%. That's it in a nutshell. Remember, it's just the first month. We're not talking big volumes here, and this will surely change, but that's where it's at. Now, you may have been hearing about mortgages and what's happening with them. Here's a quick recap of the ones that have, or the issues that have just changed according to CMHC. If you're buying a house between zero and $500,000, you need a minimum 5% down payment. For homes over that on the second $500,000, so between $500,000 and $1 million, you'll need a 10% down payment. So 5% on the first $500,000, 10% on the second $500,000. Now, the whole purpose of this is by the federal government trying to slow down, without scaring anybody, slow down the market in the areas where it is considered to be overheated, maybe going towards a bubble, and they don't want that bubble to burst. And what we're talking about is Vancouver and Toronto. When you look at the average price in Ottawa, it's $360,000. That's when you combine the residential and the condo together. So you can see that this really doesn't impact us whatsoever. And I don't have a whole lot of concern with this. I mean, if you've only got a 5% down payment, should you be buying a property that costs $1 million bucks anyhow? So anyhow, not a change here to the Ottawa market. Thank you.